So hi, hello, and welcome again, Microbehunter here today. I want to put another water sample under the microscope, and here we see some algae. At least these are the long, filaments of algae, what you see here, and they're even multicellular, because if you kind of focus through it, you're able to actually see the individual cells here as well. But the really interesting thing is actually not the algae itself, but rather that what is growing on it. I would like to direct your attention to the surface here, and you might see that it looks a little bit fuzzy, and there are other organisms growing on top of the algae, and these are actually cyanobacteria, among others. At first sight, I thought there might be some diatoms here, but when I actually zoomed in, I could actually see that the structure looks quite similar to those of cyanobacteria. So I would like to explore this a little bit in greater detail, and in order to do that, I have to go up with the magnification a bit. Yeah, when focusing, we are now able to see that the individual cells here of the large algal filament that we have, and here now we can also see the structure and the details a little bit better of those organisms that are growing on top of the algae. Yeah, and essentially this actually shows that the algal filament here must have been already in the water for a longer time to give it sufficient time for the cyanobacteria and the other organisms to start to grow on here. So what we are having here is actually a so-called a biofilm forming on the surface of this filament here. Yeah, so this is referred to as a biofilm, which is a complex mixture of algae and also bacteria, probably fungi even. Basically, they're using very often polysaccharide to actually stick to a surface. This kind of shows a little bit the complexity of nature again, and how complex the interactions are. So I would now like to go up with the magnification yet further. Yeah, the depth of field is already quite low here, but we're now looking again at the cells of the algal filament, and you see how big they are, and compare that to the cell size of the cyanobacteria, which are prokaryotes. This actually shows that on average, I know values differ, but on average, the diameter of a eukaryotic cell, like the cell of one of these algae, is approximately 10 times the diameter as of a prokaryote, as of a bacterium. Yeah, so I just wanted to show this size comparison to you. I've in this specimen also found a few other creatures. You can actually see that occasionally you're able to see some ciliates swimming around here as well. I've seen some rotifers as well. This is a very active and quite a very alive sample here. Yeah, and what's going to happen is that sooner or later, probably those cyanobacteria are going to overtake the algae, and but many of those bacteria will actually start to decompose. The organic material. Yeah, here this seems to be a what appears to be some kind of a dead rotifer. what you're able to also see here is that inside, you can also see those green structures here. And that's the food that it has eaten. And for whatever reason, it stopped living. But at least we're now able to observe a little bit better of what's inside this organism here. Just wanted to share again this this observation with you. Wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always. See you around next time. Bye-bye.